what is the future of creative collaboration? Well, one of the things that always strikes me as very odd is when we get to social media, we feel like we're being so inclusive and diverse, and we've got so many different kinds of people. But look closely at your social network, and what you're going to find out is that most of the people on your social network are simply reinforcing your ideas. They listen to the same music you do, they believe the same political stuff you do, and if anybody disagrees, you unfriend them, right? The Spanish Inquisition couldn't have thought of this. So what I want you to understand is that there's a couple things about collaborating. And the first is, when we're collaborating creatively, the first is that groups are much more likely to come up with a new idea, but that idea is much more likely to be incremental. On the other hand, individuals are much less likely to come up with a successful new idea, but that idea is going to be more radical. This is sometimes called the Einstein or the Tesla problem. So pay attention to who's in your group, and pay attention to who actually knows. Not just who's got a bigger voice, but who knows. Now, the second thing is, you want to find people who are in your blind spots, people who don't believe with all the same nonsense that you believe. The people who are supporting you and reaffirming your thoughts are not very helpful. The people who are really going to get you to that next idea are people who have different ideas that you have to respond to, that you have to work through. Finally, being in a group doesn't mean you have to have groupthink. It doesn't mean that everybody has to agree. What you're trying to do, once again, is you're trying to produce a community of constructive and respectful conflict. And through that conflict, through that constructive, creative, and respectful conflict, what you're trying to get to is higher order ideas, ideas that are new ideas. And I want you to think about this for a minute. A lot of those great creative pairs that we've seen in history, Lennon and McCartney, Watson and Crick, their great ideas came because they didn't agree, but they were willing, respectfully, to work through the idea to a higher order idea. So the future of creative collaboration is making sure you know who knows, making sure you have people in your community, in your blind spots, and making sure you work through the challenge.